Good afternoon, and we shall continue with relational algebra. Yesterday we tackled the problem of relational algebra, and we said that relational algebra is a formal query language based on a set of operations on relations. And we saw that there are a set of fundamental operations and a set of additional operations. We saw the fundamental operations, namely the select operation, the project, the Cartesian product, the union, the set difference, and the rename. This set of operations is complete in the sense that all queries of relational algebra can be formed out of these set of operations only. No other additional set is required to have a query, but we have a set of additional operators which make it easier to write queries. And today we shall now see what these additional operators are and how they can be used to write efficient queries. The additional operators are the natural join operation, the intersection operation, the division operation, the assignment operation, and the theta join operation. Before going into that, we shall quickly review the example database scheme that we were using. We were considering the simple library database scheme, which had the following attributes: account number, year of publication, title, card number, borrower's name, borrower's address, supplier name, supplier address, date of issue, price, and date of supply. We had five relation schemes: the book scheme with account number, year of publication, and title, the user scheme with card number, borrower's name, and borrower's address, supplier scheme with supplier name and supplier address, borrowed by scheme with account number, accession number, card number, and date of issue, and the supplied by scheme again with accession number, supplier name, price, and date of supply. And the star marked items are the primary keys of each of these relation schemes. The set of relations defined were the book relation on book scheme, the user relation on user scheme, supplier on supplier scheme, borrow on borrowed by scheme, and SUPP on supplied by scheme. So we shall now see all the additional operations one by one. The first additional operation which we shall see . The intersection operation, just like the union operation, is a binary operator working on two relations. So if we have R intersection S, then it works on two relations who must have same attributes. In some cases, attributes of the same type are allowed, but we will make it such that they must have the same attributes only. So intersection is defined between two relations which are identical in terms of attributes, and it returns those tuples which are common to both the relations. R intersection S, if R is a relation having attributes A, B, S is another relation having attributes A and B, and let us say that the tuples in these relations are as follows. In A we have got then R intersection S will give me a relation with the attributes A and B, and only the common item, of these two namely A1 will be there in the intersection relation. It's a simple relation, but this is not a fundamental operation in the sense that the intersection relation can be written out in terms of other relations. Can anybody tell me what the intersection relation will be? Yes, it is R minus R minus S. R minus S is those set of tuples in R which are not there, those set of tuples in R which are not there in S. And therefore, R minus S will give you the set of tuples which are there both in R as well as in S. Therefore, the intersection operation can be written down in terms of the fundamental operations. We come to the next major operation. This is denoted by the symbol suppose I have a relation R and I have another relation S. Now the first thing about natural join is let when I write down RR, I mean that R is the set of attributes, capital R is the set of attributes of the relation small r, and S means capital S is the set of attributes of the relation small s. The first condition which is to be understood is this: if R intersection S is null, that is there are no common attributes between R and S, then so one basic condition regarding natural join is it is a relation which combines two relations. So it is a binary relation and it combines two relations. Now the first thing is which a natural join requires is to understand what are the common attributes between the two relations which are to be joined. If there are no common attributes, then it is the same as the Cartesian product. That is, if we have got attributes A and B and attribute C and D, then R natural join S will have four attributes. R natural join S will have four attributes A, B, C, D, and will be the Cartesian product of R and S. This is not the major place where natural join finds its use. Natural join becomes useful when there is some commonality between the attributes. Let us take a particular example. Let R be a relation having attributes A, B and C. Let S be another relation having attributes B and D. This is an example where there is one common attribute. There may be more than one common attributes which we shall see soon. then the first thing about R natural join S is that it will be another relation having the attributes A, B, C and D. It will have the attributes A, B, C and D. So, it will have, if R is R and S is S, then R natural join S will be a relation of R union S. Now, what will be the elements? Suppose R has got three tuples and Q has got three tuples as well. Then let us understand what will be the tuples of natural join. We'll understand them by trying to do the Cartesian product, and we will impose a condition on the Cartesian product which will show us what natural join means. So while we do Cartesian product, we can do it this way. We take the first tuple and try to combine it with all of them. The rule in natural join is this tuple will combine with this tuple provided the value of the common attribute is the same. So here the value of the common attribute is B, here it is B. So this will two will combine and we will get the tuple. Now this will not combine with this because B and Q are different. So this tuple ABC with PQ will not be there in the natural join. Similarly, ABC with ET will not be there in the natural join. So this will combine with only the one where the attribute is common is same. DEF will not combine with BQ. DEF will not combine with PR, but DEF will combine with ET to give you another tuple DEFT. GHI will not combine with this, GHI will not combine with this, and GHI will not combine with this. So now in the natural join we will have only two tuples. So let us see what expression we get for a natural join. The expression we get is formed out of the Cartesian product provided the common attributes have got the same value. So in this particular case where we have got two relations, R is A, B, C and S is B, D, then R natural join S gives me, it is formed out of R cross S, but it selects only those tuples, since B is the common attribute between this, so it selects those tuples for which R dot B is equal to S dot B. And it will project out R dot A, R dot B, R dot C and S dot D. So the natural join of R and S is written like this. This query is very useful in a number of situations. So let us go back to our example and we will see what this query means. So we will revisit our example. We have got book and we have got borrow. We have got book and borrow. So let us see what book is a relation. Book has got attributes: accession number, year of publication, and title. And user or borrow has got accession number, card number, and date of issue. So book, natural join, borrow will be a relation with accession number, year of publication, title, card number, and date of issue. And book join borrow will be giving you the accession number, the year of publication, the title of the book, who has borrowed that book, and the date of issue of the borrowing of the book. By definition, book natural join borrow is book cross borrow. Select out those for which, since accession number is the only common attribute between book and borrow, we select out those tuples from the Cartesian product which have got the same accession numbers. That is, we want to match out only those book and the accession number which is common in the Cartesian product. And we select out all the union of all the attributes. This is the definition of natural join here. Therefore, using that definition, we get this. And if we do okay, I'll take another example. Let us see what this query means now. We did a natural join of book and borrow. So we got the accession number, year of publication, title, card number, and date of issue of all the books. The books which are not borrowed, which are presently available in the library and not issued to anybody, will not be there in this natural join relationship. We selected out those for which the card number is F53 and we projected the title. So using this, we have been able to answer the query . This is the query which is answered by this expression. Because we did a natural join, we found out the books and the details of the date of issue, the accession number, the title, the year of publication, and we took out the title. Normally we could not have got it from any one of these relations, because the card number is in borrow relation and the book title is in book relation. And this is how we have got the title of all the books issued under card number F53. Now let us try and answer a similar question. find out the title of all books issued by Vijay. That is, find out the titles of all books issued by Vijay. To do this, let us go back to, from book we will get the title, from borrow we will get the accession number and the card number, and from user we will get card number, name and address. So we will get the name from here, but we will neither get the will not get the accession number of the book from here. To get the accession number of the book issued under this name, we will have to go to borrow relation, do a natural join between user and borrow, and get the accession number. But still we will not get the card number of the book. To get the card number of the book, then this natural join must be we must do a natural join again with book, and from that we will get the title. So in order to solve this problem, we will have to first do a natural join between user and borrow. This will give us the combination of the card number and the accession numbers and the names of all the books. Now we want only the books of Vijay. So we can select out Vijay from here. In fact, we could have selected out Vijay from user itself. We can select out Vijay from here, and we can say borrower name equal to Vijay. We could have first selected out Vijay from inside here also. That would also have been identical. Now we have got this, but still we have not got the title of the book. In order to get the title of the book, we have to do a natural join with. Now the question is, there are some common attributes between these two. Now when you write down B name, it is fine, B name is only of user. But natural join takes out only those tuples which are common even on the common attributes. So you don't have to mention the, explicitly you will not have to mention the name of the relation which you are using in the attribute. Through this, now you have got the user, the book that has been borrowed, and the title of the book is available in all the tuples here. So from here we just can project out the title. While this is a correct answer to this query, as we have seen, this is also correct. And if you think a little, this is an odd way to write out the query, but this is also correct. User and book have got no common attributes. User and book have got no common attributes. So what this will do is, this will do the Cartesian product here. Now this has got the attributes of both user and book, and the attributes will be card number, name, address, accession number, year of publication, and title. And borrow will have accession number, card number, and date of issue. So there are two common attributes between these two relations. So let us quickly understand what does natural join do when there are more than one common attributes between two relations. Let us have a relation R, A, B, C, and a relation S, B, C, D. The natural join of R and S will have only the common union of the two attributes, so it will have four attributes: A, B, C, and D only. That is the first thing about natural join. It will have the union of the set of attributes of the individual relations. Let this have got four attributes, four tuples, and this has got three tuples: A, B, C, A, C, D, P, Q, R, Q, S, T, B, C, M, Q, R, S, B, R, M. Now we are trying to combine in the natural join. We'll try and combine this with this. Here B does not match with B, so this will not match. Here A, B, C, here B, C, M. The question is that B matches with B is fine, but C must also match with C. It is not that any one of them matches in the attributes. If this is BC, then this must also be BC. So here it matches. ABC matches with BCM. So we have got the tuple ABCM. ABC will not match with this. ABC will not match with B or M. Though B matches with B, C does not match with R. Therefore, this will not match with this. ACD 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 will not match with this. Therefore, there will be no matches. PQR will not match with QST. PQR will not match with BCM. PQR will match with QRS, because Q matches with Q and R matches with R. So we will have another tuple, PQRS. And PQR will not match with BR, though R matches with R. But Q does not match with B. So now we will have only two tuples in the natural join of R and S. So it is important to remember that in natural join, if there are more than one common attributes, all the attributes must match to form the natural join. So we come back to what we were doing, and we come back to, we had user, join, borrow, join, book. And we had the other option, which was user, join, book, join, borrow. Now, are these two identical, is the question. User has got a common attribute with borrow, that is card number. And whatever is formed out of this has got a common attribute with book, that is accession number. On the other hand, user and book have got no common attributes. And the join of these two has got both the common attributes. So user, join, borrow will give you the name, the address, the card number, and the accession number and date of issue of the books borrowed by every user. And that join with the book will give you the corresponding title and of the book. Here, user cross book will give you all possible combinations of user and book that a user can borrow, that a user could have borrowed. User join book will give you all possible combinations. Among them, only some are valid. But those which are valid are the combinations of card number, accession number. This is the valid combination of card number and accession number of the books borrowed by individual users. So if this Cartesian product is joined with borrow, you will get effectively the title, the year of all the books borrowed by each and every user. The relationship between accession number and card number is here. So only those tuples in user cross borrow which have this relationship will be chosen in the natural join. So whatever you get out of this, you will also get out of this. That is to say that natural join is not only an associative operation, it is also a commutative operation. So R, natural join S, natural join T is the same as R, natural join S, natural join T. It is also the same as R, natural join T, natural join S. It is also the same as any other combination. So we write like this. This natural join is very useful to solve a number of queries. And we will see one more query before finishing off the section on natural join. The query is, find out the names of all the suppliers who have supplied books issued by Vijay. We'll go back to our... The book scheme has got suppliers, so we've got, we can start from the username Vijay. We have to find out the name of the supplier who has supplied books issued by Vijay. to know which book has been issued by Vijay, we have to go to the borrowed by, to the borrow relation using the borrowed by scheme through the card number, by natural join with the card number. Now from this we will get the accession number of the book, and from the accession number of the book we will get the name of the supplier through the supplied by scheme. Because the accession number of the book is a primary key. So a solution to that will be, you will get the user, the accession number of the book borrowed by the user by natural join through card number, and from the accession number you will get the book supplied by a particular supplier through the accession number, by natural join through the accession number. You will select out Vijay, you could have put this inside here, doesn't matter, and then you will project out the name of the supplier. So you can write this down very easily using natural join. You need not even put the brackets, just do this. And project out the S name. So natural join helps us to write out queries which otherwise using the fundamental operations would have taken us a huge amount of writing. Finally, we formally define the natural join operation in terms of the fundamental operations. Let R be a relation with R, S be a relation of the attributes S. This is a set of attributes. Let R intersection S be the attributes A1, A2 to AK. Then R natural join S will select out all the common attributes. It will first do a Cartesian product and it will select out the common portions R dot A1, since A1 to AK is common to both R and S. So R dot A1 equal to S dot A1, R dot A2 equal to S dot A2. And project out the union of the sets of attributes. So it can be written in terms of the fundamental operations, but it is very useful to have this operation otherwise. The next operation that we shall discuss is the division or the quotient operation. The quotient operation, I will take an example. Let R be a relation of two attributes and S be a relation of one attribute. The first criteria in the division operation is that when you write R divides S, then the attributes of S must be a subset of the attributes of R. So if you have got RR and SS, then S must be a subset of R. let us have a set of 7 tuples here, PA, QA, PB, PC, QT, MA, QB, and let us have 2 tuples here. R divides S, the attributes of R divides S the attributes of R divides S will be R minus S. The attributes of R divides S will be R minus S. So it will be, in this particular example, it will be only A. And it will contain those tuples which have all of them here. In the sense, PA, if PA is here and A is present here, then PB must also be present for P to be present here. That is, if P is a tuple of R divides S, then both PA and PB must be present in R. Here PA is there, PB is there, some other things can also be there, we are not bothered. But both PA and PB must be there. QA is there and QB is there. Therefore, Q will also be there in R divides S. P is there, Q is there. Let us check M. MA is there, but MB is not there. So M will not be there in R divides S. So R divides S is the set of all portions of the attributes of R minus S such that this attribute has got combinations for all possible values in S. Let us take this query. From borrow, we select out those tuples for card number 53 and find out the accession number. So this gives us the set of books. This gives us accession number. This gives us the set of books borrowed by under card number F53. And let us take this gives us the set of books supplied under the supplier names. This supplier name has supplied this accession number, this supplier name has supplied this accession number. And let us see what this will give us. This will give us as answer to these two, the answer will be a tuple, will be a relation having this attribute. and it will be those supplier names. If there is a supplier name X here, such that this X is there for all possible accession numbers present here, then only this supplier name will be given here. So this will return the name of that supplier, if it exists, who has supplied all the books which are issued to card number 53. If a supplier has issued all the books supplied to card number 53, then that name will come. I'll repeat. Suppose there is a supplier named Narosa, and Narosa has supplied these three books. And there is another supplier called Rice Publishing who has supplied this book. Then Narosa, since accession number is a key here as well as here, we cannot normally in our relationship, we cannot have Rice also one person supplying the same book to two different people, isn't it? That we cannot have. But what we can have is we can have a person, a single person may have supplied all the books. If a single person has supplied all the books, then that person will be a candidate key in this, candidate for being in the solution of the division. If Narosa has supplied all the books here, then we'll have Narosa this accession number, Narosa this accession number, Narosa this accession number, Narosa this accession number here. Then Narosa will qualify here. We'll see a slightly different example, similar, but which will help us a little better. This gives us the titles of all the books issued under card number F53. Alright? This gives us the titles. The previous one gave us the accession numbers of the books borrowed here. But this borrow does not contain the titles. So to get the titles of the books issued under card F53, we've got this. Now here, instead of getting the accession numbers, we have got the supplier name and the title of the book supplied by this supplier. Alright. Now we divide these two. Divide this by this. Then what we get is a relation which has again got the result of these two is got supplier name. This relation is like this. And this relation, this is this relation has got only title. And the result of the division is going to give this relation. So, instead of getting the accession number which was a key, we have got the titles of the book. So, he has borrowed compiler design, algorithms, machines. Now Narosa may have supplied all the three books but that the corresponding book may not be issued to him. That is, the book having that accession number may not be issued to him. Narasa may have supplied another copy of the book. So if Narasa supplies these three books, then Narasa qualifies here. It does not mean that Narasa has to supply the same book with that same accession number issued to card number 53. Narasa may have supplied other copies of the book. So unlike the previous one where we could have got only one solution, here we can get many other solutions, because more than one book of the same title can be present in the library. So now we have got by this is that give me the names of the suppliers who have supplied all the books, in the sense that who have supplied at least one copy of all the titles which are issued to card number F53. This is different from this, because accession number was the primary key, you could have had only one solution, if at all. And here you can have a solution, even though Narasa may not have supplied even one of the copies to this person. He just supplies other copies of the same title. So division allows us to solve the problem of containment, all for all. And it is another useful query. The division operation can also be written down in terms of the standard primitive operations. This is a solution to the division operation. I will explain what this solution means, but let us see what this solution is first. It is pi r minus s, so r is r, S is S. It is pi R minus S R cross S, whole thing minus R, take pi R minus S and subtract it from R minus S R. So let us see what it means. Let us see the first part. So R is R and S is S. This gives us only the attributes of R which are not in S in the relation R. Cross S gives us all possible combinations that can occur between the attributes R and S presently. Minus R now, this part has got R as the set of attributes, because this is R minus S cross S, this is R. Minus R will give you those tuples which are not there in R. This part will give you those tuples which are not there in R, because this, you take out R minus S, you get all possible combinations. Cross S, minus R will give you those tuples which are not there in R. You find out only the R minus S portions. So these are the attributes of R which are not there in R minus S, which are not there in R, and you this will give you R divides S. There is another operation called the assignment operation, which does the standard assignment. And you can use it as you were asking in the previous day. If I have a temporary relation T and I do pi of A of R join S, and then I can do another temporary relation Q saying M join T, and I can use it in a sequential program by assigning this temporary relation, the relation this, and then I can use it again. But here again, all queries which can be written by assignment operations, can also be written without the assignment operation in a bigger query. I just embed this thing here and I will get this query. So any query which I have which is using assignment operations can also be written without using assignment operations. So we will stop here. These are the additional operations of relational algebra which are useful for solving problems using relational algebra. So we have done the stand fundamental operations and the additional operations. We shall see some other operations relating to insert, delete and other things later on when we come to actual query languages.